Okay, good morning boys. In the last session we have studied about instantaneous velocity and instantaneous acceleration and how to calculate instantaneous velocity and instantaneous acceleration when a position vector is given, and we have solved some numerical problems. Today we will study motion of an object in a plane with constant acceleration. Motion of an object in a plane with constant acceleration means an object is moving on, let us say, xy plane with uniform acceleration. Acceleration is constant. Suppose if the object is moving in xy plane with constant acceleration, then we can write acceleration vector as constant. If v naught is the initial velocity, let v naught vector be the initial velocity at time t equal to 0. Initial time t equal to 0, let v naught be the initial velocity. And vector v be the final velocity at any time t. At final time t, let vector v be the final velocity. Then we know how to calculate average acceleration. Average acceleration is equal to change in velocity divided by time taken for that change in velocity. Average acceleration is equal to delta v by delta t. So if you calculate average acceleration in a given interval of time t, that itself becomes the acceleration in that situation. The reason is the acceleration is constant throughout. Uniform acceleration we have defined earlier. What is uniform acceleration? When an object, if an object is increasing its velocity in equal amounts, in equal intervals of time, it is said to be in uniform acceleration. Or in general we can say, if an object changes its velocity in equal amounts, in equal intervals of time, then it is said to be in uniform acceleration. So if you calculate average acceleration between any two given intervals of time, that average acceleration will be same for any given interval of time. Therefore, if you calculate average acceleration a bar, we get v minus v naught by t minus 0, where t is final time and 0 is the initial time. So this itself becomes acceleration vector. Acceleration vector is equal to vector v minus vector v naught divided by t. So this gives us what is equation number 1, that is first equation of motion. Taking this t towards left hand side, we get vector v minus vector v naught is equal to vector a into t. Vector v minus vector v naught is equal to vector a into t, where vector v is equal to vector v naught plus a t. Just taking this t naught to the right hand side, we get vector v equal to v naught plus a t. So this is what is known as the first equation of motion. So in the previous case, we did not use the vector sign. Now we are using the vector sign. It's having both magnitude as well as direction. Not only that, since it is a motion on an xy plane, this vector v will be having x component as well as y component. Vx as well as vy will be its components. Similarly, v naught x and v naught y will be the x and y components of vector v naught, and vector a will be having ax and ay as x component and y component of acceleration vector a. So that we will write little later. Now once we get first equation of motion, now we will think of second equation of motion. The second equation of motion is a calculation of displacement. We know displacement is calculated as change in position vectors. Final position vector minus initial position vector gives us the displacement vector. Let r naught be the initial position vector of the object at time t equal to 0. Let r naught vector represent the initial position vector at time t equal to 0. Then it's a final position vector at time t. At time t, its final position vector, let it be r.
means when it is having initial velocity v naught, its position is r naught. When it is having final velocity v, its position is vector r. That's the meaning. So we want to calculate displacement. So by definition, displacement is vector r minus vector r naught, change in position vector. That gives us delta r. So using this delta r, now we can calculate the actual displacement. Then how to calculate displacement? Go by this earlier definition. If you remember, average velocity is equal to delta r by delta t. Average velocity is equal to delta r by delta t, where delta r is displacement and time, delta t is the time taken, total displacement by total time taken. Therefore, we want to calculate delta r. So delta r is equal to v bar into delta t. Delta r is equal to v bar into delta t. This equation I am going to use. Therefore, delta r vector is equal to v bar into delta t. Then what is v bar in this case? Look here. Initial velocity is v. Initial velocity is v naught. Final velocity is p. Therefore, v bar can be calculated, where v bar is equal to v naught plus b by 2. V bar is equal to v naught plus b by 2 is the average velocity in the time interval t. So if you substitute this, thus we get delta r is equal to v bar v naught plus v divided by 2 into t. V naught plus v divided by 2 into t, just as substituted the value of average velocity. Now what is the final velocity? We know from equation 1, v naught plus at is the final velocity. Substitute this using first equation. Thus we get v naught vector plus v naught plus at into t divided by t. This is the time interval, t minus 0. Therefore, we got t. Now simplify this. V naught plus V naught becomes 2 V naught. 2 V naught divided by 2 becomes 2, 2 cancels. So you are left with V naught. V naught into T becomes V naught T. Directly I am simplifying this. V naught plus V naught into T becomes 2 V naught T. 2 V naught T by 2 becomes V naught T plus A into T into T, A T square, A T square by 2. So A T square by 2 I will write as this. So thus the change in position vector displacement is given by R minus R naught is equal to, so this gives us displacement, that is second equation of motion. So first equation of motion and second equation of motion, these are the equations of motion for a particle in xy plane. So I can list here vector v equal to v naught plus at and vector r minus r naught. This is the displacement equal to v naught t plus half a t square. So in the one dimensional motion, there was no question of usage of these vectors. It was having only one component, that is a x component. Now the difference between the one dimensional motion and the second dimensional motion is that here it is having a vector in xy plane. Vector in xy plane means it's having x components as well as x component as well as y component. So these x components and y components we'll write here. See here. Here, for example, v v naught vector can be written as v naught x I cap plus v naught y j cap. P naught is equal to v naught x I cap plus v naught y j cap. In one dimensional motion, we have taken this one as u. U as the initial speed, initial velocity. Here it is v naught. That's the difference. So it is having x component as well as y component. Similarly, final velocity vector can also be written as vxi plus vyj. So in the same way, I can write the components for vector r and components for vector r naught. Already I have written the components. So components for velocity I have written. So in the same way, I can write the components for vector a and vector r. Now, okay. Now we will write the same equations in terms of their x components and y components. V naught x plus ax t becomes v. This is the x component of velocity. Y component of velocity can be written as v naught y plus ay t, where vector A can be in the same manner, vector A can be written as vector AX I cap plus AY J cap. So vector A is equal to AX I cap plus AY J cap. So thus I can write VX, X component of velocity vector is equal to V naught X plus AX T, and Y component of velocity as v naught y plus ay t. In the same way, we can write even for the delta r. See here, in the case of delta r, if you write the equation for vector r, vector r can be written as x I cap plus y j cap. Vector r naught can be written as x naught I cap plus y naught j cap. So displacement is also having x component as well as y component. So thus I can write, these are the first I write x and y components of velocity vector. These are the x and y components of velocity vector. Now similarly, x and y components of displacement vector. First I will write x component of displacement vector. So r vector minus r naught. R minus r naught can be written as x minus x naught. So x minus x naught is equal to v naught x t plus half ax t square. V naught x t plus half ax t square. Similarly, y component of displacement can be written as v naught y t plus half ax t square. So this I can write x component of displacement, and this is y component of displacement. If it is motion in three dimensions, if it is motion in space, in addition to x and y component, it will be having z component also. Means it will be having vector A equal to AXI plus AYJ plus AZK. Vector R will be XI cap plus YJ cap plus ZK cap. R naught vector will be X naught I cap plus Y naught J cap plus Z naught K cap. So that is the only difference. So in addition to X and Y, it will have Z component of displacement also. That is Z minus Z naught is equal to V naught ZT plus half AZ T square. Here it is AY. AY T square, and Z component will be having Z minus Z naught is equal to V naught ZT plus half AZ T square. So for an object moving on XY plane, its velocity vector and displacement vector will be having both X component as well as Y components. Similarly, even its acceleration components, acceleration vector will also be having X component as well as Y component. So once we solve the numerical problems, then we will understand the meaning of these components. Okay, let us solve one problem, then you will understand the meaning of X coordinate and Y coordinates of the position vectors and X and Y components of velocity vectors. Let us see this problem. A particle starts from origin at time t equal to 0. It starts from origin at time t equal to 0 with a velocity of 10 j cap meter per second. It is moving with a velocity of 10 j cap meter per second, means at time t equal to 0, its velocity is this one. This is the initial velocity, and it moves in a xy plane. It is moving into a xy plane with constant acceleration. The acceleration value is given 8 i cap plus 2 j cap meter per second square. These are the given things. Question number A: at what time is the x coordinate of a particle? At what time is the x component of a particle becomes 16 meter? What is y coordinate of that particle at that time? If x component of particle is 16 meter, find out the time for which it takes 16 meter. This is first question. And at the same time, what is its y coordinate? You are asked to find out. Second question is, what is the speed of the particle at that time? Now, we will solve this problem. First, let us write the given things. Origin means R naught is equal to 0. It's a origin. It's starting from origin. Therefore, R naught is equal to 0. It means it's a X naught I cap plus Y naught J cap. If you just write it, both are having 0, 0. Therefore, X naught is equal to 0, Y naught is equal to 0. Means origin is having coordinates 0, 0. Therefore, X naught is 0, Y naught is 0. Now its initial vector is given. Initial velocity vector V naught is equal to 10 J meter per second. 10 j meter per second, this can be also written in terms of V naught x I cap plus V naught y j cap. V naught x I cap plus V naught y j cap. See, here it is having only y component. It means the velocity of the particle is along y axis. It doesn't have x component of velocity. Therefore, I can write V naught x is 0, V naught y is 10 using this. Therefore, I can write V naught x is 0, V naught y is 10 using this given data. Now, acceleration vector, constant acceleration vector is given. Acceleration vector, we know it is given by ax I cap plus ay j cap. So, this is given here. That's equal to 8 i cap plus 2 j cap. So this implies AX is equal to 8, AY is equal to 2. So these are the given things. Now you are asked to find out at what time the X coordinate becomes 16 meter. So X means final position vector. Final position vector R can be written as X I cap plus Y j cap. And we know the equation for change in position, that is displacement. Displacement delta R is equal to vector R minus vector R naught, which just now we have written is equal to V naught vector into T plus half A vector into T square. So I can write now in terms of x component and y component. Therefore, x minus x naught is equal to v naught. V naught vector, I can write in x component, becomes v naught x, v naught x t plus half ax t square. V naught x t plus half ax t square. Similarly, y component can be written as y minus y naught is equal to v naught y t plus half ax ay, half ay t square. Now x minus x naught is given, that is 16 meter. At this 16 meter, what is the value of time t? So use this equation for x component. X is equal to 16, x naught is 0. So I can write, therefore, x is 16, 16 minus 0. 16 minus 0 is equal to, what is V naught x? V naught x is 0. 0 into t becomes 0 plus half ax. What is ax? Ax is 8. Half 8 into t square. So thus it becomes 16 equal to 2 ones are 2 fours are. So 4 t square. This implies t square is equal to 16 by 4. T square is equal to 4. Therefore we get time t equal to 2 seconds. Means after 2 seconds the x coordinate of the particle becomes 16 meter. Then what happens to y coordinate of the particle exactly at the same time? We can substitute the value of t here and values of v naught y and a y, we will get the y coordinates. Now let us see. We know y naught. Y naught is 0. So I can write the same way y minus 0 equal to v naught y. V naught y is 10. 10 into t. We want to find out the value of t already we got 2 seconds, yes. So 10 into t, 10 into t plus 1/2 ay. What is ay value? Ay is 2. Ax is 8, Ay is 2. 2 into t square. So y becomes 2. Just substitute the value of t. T is 2. So 10 2s are 20 plus 2 cancels. T square. T square is 4. So y becomes equal to 24 meter. So this is y at t equal to 2 seconds. Thus we got x coordinate also as well as y coordinate. X coordinate is 16, y coordinate is 24. So this is 16, 24. This is how we got. The next one is what is the speed of the particle at that time? We have to calculate what is the speed of the particle. speed of the particle can be calculated as magnitude of velocity. So first we'll calculate velocity. We have velocity equal to v naught plus a t. First equation. So first I will write x component. V naught vector plus a t. X component of velocity. X component of velocity is given by v x is equal to x. When you write component, you do not take any vector sign. So v x is equal to v naught x plus a x. Now we know what is v naught x. V naught x is 0. So thus it becomes 0 plus ax. Ax is 8. 8 into 2. So thus it becomes vx is equal to 60. Therefore, x component vx is equal to 16 meter per second. Similarly, we will calculate what is vy. Similarly, vy is equal to v naught y plus ay t. First we calculate x component, then we are calculating y component. Thus, v naught y, what is v naught y? V naught y is 10. 10 plus ay, what is the value of ay? 2 into 2. So thus it becomes 10 plus 4. 10 plus 4, that is 14. Thus we get vy equal to 14 meter per second. So thus we got x component as well as y component. You find out the magnitude of velocity vector, that itself becomes the speed. Therefore, speed is equal to magnitude of velocity vector. And we know how to find out the magnitude of velocity vector. When vx and vy components are given, then magnitude of velocity vector is given by square root of vx square plus vy square. Thus it becomes square root of vx 16 square plus 14 square. So 16 square, if you calculate, 16s are, how much it will be? 256. And 14s are 196. So that is the square root of 256 plus 196. So if you work it out, 256 plus 196, it comes out to be 452. Therefore, you can write. So here, I will write this. Therefore, speed is equal to square root of 452. Square root of 452. So square of 22 is 484. So it will be lying in between 21 and 22. So if you calculate this, it comes out to be 21.6. Okay, 21.26 meter per second. Thus we got the second part, speed of the particle at that time. Speed of the particle at that time is b equal to 21.26 meter per second. So like this, you are having different types of numerical problems. So solve it from the textbook. If you download this mycbseguide.com, I have already told you. You can once again write mycbseguide.com. This is the official website of CBSE. So through this, if you download, if you open 11th class, then you will get physics, chemistry and all. In physics, if you just go through the details, you will get textbook PDF. So topic wise PDF will be available. You just download the topic wise PDF. In that you will get the text. So solve the problem from the text, numerical problem, solve examples from the text, and then go to the exercise and solve the problems. So this is how you are supposed to solve. If you have doubts, you can again ask me to my WhatsApp number. Thank you. Have a good day.